You are watching Kit Cabinet, and this is the inbox review of the Revell P47M Thunderbolt in 1/72 scale. Okay, so Revell's P47M has been around for quite a while now, but it's still a very good kit. So let's have a look inside. Okay, here are some sprues. Let's have a closer look. Recessed panel lining. Nicely detailed, very fine, looking good. Due to its age, there's some flash forming here, but nothing a hobby knife and some sandpaper can't solve. The surface still looks very much okay. And there's even some inner wheel well detail here, which looks very, very good. Ah, it says here 1999, so just over 20 years old. And here the fuselage, the surface is equally nicely detailed, and you have a very nice cockpit here. Again, some flash here, but for older models you just have to deal with that. A seat with seat belts molded in, that's cool. Ooh, there's a lot of flash on this tail spine here. And we have some interior detail here, some sidewall detail as well. And so there's more your tail planes, while the external detail looks nice overall. So yeah, there's one thingy. The P47M was like one of the latest P47 Thunderbolts that were built, and it had a upgraded engine. And you'd normally expect that it would have the latest model propeller as well, and that would be the Curtiss Electric asymmetrical propeller, but they didn't. The P47Ms had the Curtiss Electric symmetrical blades, and as you can see, these blades are not symmetrical. So for this version you'd have to sand off a piece here so that you get symmetrical blades. Revell has another kit of a P47, which is this one, and this one is a lot trickier to get nowadays. P47D30, which is basically the same model except for one single sprue, the P47M sprue, has the reinforced crankcase front for the engine of the R2800C series, with which you can recognize that there's a lot of bolts to the front face of the engine, and of course these rockets and fuel tanks. And the D version, they have this sprue included. The plastic is in silver gray, by the way, with a smooth front for the B series engine, and different drop tanks. So here's a flat belly tank, some standard drop tanks here, and some bombs. And there's something awkward here. You have this box of the P47M with bombs and a flat fuel tank, and the bombs and the flat fuel tank are included in this boxing. And which brings us to another thing. For the P47M you get these unguided rockets, and that was a loadout that was, I've never seen it. I won't say that it's never been used, but I can't find any proof of it, so it's a very unusual loadout for a P-47M. Also, the style of drop tanks is a bit awkward, but yeah, you'll need that engine part anyway. So that's a bit awkward. The transparencies, you get like a bubble canopy and a landing light here. And it looks right enough in shape and everything, but there is some distortion. The plastic is a bit on the thick side and it's not too clear. There's some fogging around here near the lower ridge of the canopy. So you'll have to you might have to polish that one and maybe add some future to it. Get a nice clean shine. There's also some, yeah, it's not the best casting, but it's sort of doable. Okay, so here are the instructions in German, in English, and a lot more blah blah blah. Okay, you have your color coding here in Revell colors all. And for the for one of the versions, you have to mix your colors for the one. For this one, you have to mix your dark blue and your light blue camouflage. And it's probably best if you like look up some pictures on the internet. There are a couple of wartime photographs, color photographs, which will give you an indication what the real colors might have looked like, because there's a lot of debate what these colors, this dark blue and this light blue, actually were. It's probably mixed. There were like three squadrons and they had also like three different color schemes, and there are two included in the box, which we'll see in a minute. So there's a lot of mixing going on here. Yeah, your sprue map, and the construction is actually, there's a lot of parts. It's a lot of detail, but it's not really a very difficult kit. So also for beginning modelers, you actually get a very nice kit. It's nicely detailed. Good. Yeah, and these stores, of course, it's, yeah, the rockets here. Okay, and here we have the color schemes. So this one is the one that's also on the box with the blues that you have to mix. And this one has a slightly different color scheme. This one has a green and gray scheme. So that's one that you can build as well. The decal sheet. Yeah, what can we say about this? It's there are great decals, nice and thin, very nicely in register. And the two different versions here, the blue one and the gray-green one. And they're very good decals. So I just showed this variant of the kit. And let's just have a look where the differences are. Of course, this sprue that I just showed, and basically also the decals. Now, this version has a lot of stenciling, as you can see. There's like two versions. The one on the box, the balls out, American. And you have also decals for a French version. The quality of the decals is great, again. Nicely in register, looking good. But as you can see, there's like a truckload of stenciling. And that's possibly because the American version is a silver colored one. So you'll be able to see a lot of these stencils. Possibly. So the instructions, instruction is the same as the B47M. And here are the color schemes. The American version, balls out. And here, the French version, which is colored in dark green. And there's also something awkward here. You'll notice these drop tanks are this variant. And you get in this kit the standard drop tanks. Some things may have been mixed up here with the release of these two kits. So in conclusion, a very nice kit, and I have happen to have one here under construction, and yeah, it's going together very well, looking good. Never mind the foam pieces, that's for the airbrush and the primer. But yeah, this thing goes together as a very good kit. So, cheap, good looking, readily available, a very nice kit.